Hi, I'm back. The card stuff you'll see at the top is actually from Beatus's deck. I was just watching him for a little bit. Let's go ahead and finish up the arena run I was doing, and then probably do at least one more, if not two. Today, I don't think this is gonna end up getting posted on YouTube because it's gonna be super copyright content ID-ish. To the point of being really questionable. Because I'm gonna play, called Francis the Mute Revisited. It is a cut of Francis the Mute by Mars Volta that was done by fans that cuts out a lot of stuff the producers did that was super weird. And it was just like really a really odd decision, like 8 minutes of frogs croaking for no fucking reason, just shit like that. This was just really bad. And cutting an entire song from the album that was really important and kind of crucial to making the whole album make sense. A couple things like that. But it turns out it's really hard to find for some reason now. But I have it, and we'll listen to it, and it makes the album really good. And Discord... As far as like sharing your audio, you can do that with VoiceMeter, like through Discord, which if you're a streamer, you really should learn how to use VoiceMeter at this point, because it's free, it's good, it lets you do all sorts of stuff with your audio, it lets you do EQ work, it gives you a good noise gate, a good compressor built in, like it's a good ass program. Look up VoiceMeter Banana and probably use it. I actually, it's freeware and I donated because that's how much I fucking love this program. It has made my life so much easier. But let's go ahead and start listening to some good-ass Mars Volta, and on top of that, I guess we'll play cards while we're at it. It's not showing my whole deck right now. It's something weird. So we're gonna probably pay for that for a while. God, I think I just keep eating damage. He doesn't play anything else. I don't like this. That sucks a lot. Oh, thank God. It's a lot of mixing, it's a lot of editing, like there were just like minutes and minutes of like random ambient noises and shit that were really annoying. in the original album for like no good reason. And it pulls a lot of stuff like that out that just like serve no purpose. God, I think it's just ping flame cannon and hope for the best. That was the best.
Mascara glass. The frost wolves stand ready.
Yeah, they have Leafle no matter what. I didn't think this deck ended up very good. I didn't want to say anything yesterday, so I'm kind of burning through it pretty quickly. I was dead a while ago. Okay. Showing my deck, and I don't know why it's driving me crazy. Thank you. It's a bit of a weird album. I'll give people that. And the first song's really, really kind of slower. Especially like the mid portions.
Don't worry, Lux. The cavalry's here. You're in trouble now. From your viewing lens, a depth perception languished in the night. All my life. Oh, yeah, you got it.
That's a really good target. Alright, the hard part here is, do I polymorph? Do I polymorph blood fin? I mean, that's a really good chance then that I get something. Alright, it's just the ping for free. I'm not too worried about any buffs. Better. I'm really focusing to see if I can pull any wins out of this deck. I really don't want to go 0-3. It happens, but I'm hoping it doesn't happen here. Ah, that's yellow. That's like the worst card. The hex? Oh god, another Fire Guard Destroyer. Yeah. Nine mana and it's a clear. Like it. I've got a huge card. Helps me develop board. This had 6 plus 5, I had 12. I prefer having control. However, if both of these hit, I can just put the Stranglethorn and kind of sit on it. Probably what I'll do. Okay, I'm glad I didn't push it for damage to guard. Oh man. Reinforcements requested. Yeah. There we go. Yeah, Hearth Arena is pretty good. I recommend taking it with a grain of salt, especially because God, I can never pronounce his name right. Adwcta, I think, and Merps. Those two dudes were the ones who originally set all that stuff up, and then they got burned by the site's owner and like everything else. Basically, he pulled a bunch of like, well, it's not Ellen writing bullshit, and tried to fuck him. So they ain't too pleased about none of that. Now, the question is here. Do I plop a 6-6 on the board? And I gotta say, it... Oh, God, that sounds really good. But I really do prefer having it where it is right now. So I think I just play the card draw. Ping. If he doesn't trade, though, I will be hitting face and then getting a 6-6. Gonna go face with that. I'd be so glad if he goes face with that, because otherwise, I mean, I have 5-2 and ping to remove that. Oh my god. Yeah, man. First things first, ping to see what we draw. God, it's a taunt too. Do I even trade all that? Or do I just rush here? I mean, I guess I do, because then... Oh, but I can't now, because I pinged. Let's think. So we have 11... We have 7, 12, 17, 19, and we'll have a 6-6 and a heckler. He has 13 on board, and it's shaman. Oh god, 10, 17, 23. Okay, yeah, we just heckled. Ping Roaring Torches game. Hey, didn't go 0-3. I'll have to edit the run afterwards because it's still checking it weird. Third thing too is a lot of times you'll think it's a bad deck, but it's actually like totally workable. A lot of times solid is better than, you know, like absurd. in a couple spots. There's a saying in drafts at Magic the Gathering stuff that uncommons win games. What three drops do I have? I don't really have any good three drops. And don't really have any great two drops. I'm honestly willing to keep this. Yeah, I saw the card reveal, and man, I gotta be honest, I don't know how they're gonna make that warrior card work. It doesn't seem good. There might be some crazy combo, but like, man, it doesn't seem good. Maybe that's just me being dumb, but like, God, it seems bad. Like, I'm thinking this tentacles farm, is it going to be like a death rattle off of something else? That's like the only thing I can think of that would make it, like, make any sense. Because it's a 2-2 for 5, like... Also, thanks Samurai Hitman for the sub, just caught it. But yeah, man, a 2 attack, 2 durability weapon for 5? I don't really care that it's reusable at that point. Like, it's a bit much, is all I'm saying. We're just gonna get a spider tank. And a master spell, I guess. And I'm just gonna keep this stealth. And like the rogue legendary they showed, it seems interesting, and it's a really good combo enabler, and all the spells or toxins or whatever seem pretty good, but 4 mana for a 3-2 is really rough. If the spells were free, it would be amazing, and if it cost 3, it would be absolutely fantastic, but like at 4, I can't read it. It's kind of the hard part. I really can't put a read on whether it's good or not. Oh, this is such a rushy deck. Oh my god, I can't believe I'm mass dispelling to shut down his card draw. Am I doing that? God, I don't really have good control though. Like, I'm just gonna keep sinking damage. Yeah, I gotta do it. Yeah, I like the toxins themselves, but it's like... Oh, that sucks. Oh man, this is where I really wish I would have had some more board wipe. Well, at least we have a polymorph. Alright, fuck it. And this is just a 3-3 for 3. Can't believe I think I'm gonna bomb lobber just to get bored totally. Is it worth it? No. No, don't be stupid, Ty. Grand Crusader, see what we get. King the sheep because it's a beast. That's also a beast though. Fuck, they all are. I like Renounce Darkness. That one's pretty good. Kill command on that. That is really good for me, actually. I could use a taunt right now, though. Yeah, we flame cannon it. What? Are you serious? Oh my god. That's insane. Play this, I can develop board a little bit. That puts me at 8. Forgotten Torch removes it. 5. And then lets me put a Stranglethorn down, which is pretty solid removal. Five is not a good amount of health, though. Like, that gives me 3 turns, because I don't have any healing. God. That's objective one here. I have 9 in hand. 8 on board. Alright, that gives me 15, 9 in hand. If I live this turn and he doesn't clear anything, that's lethal. Alright, dude, do you have like a 1 damage spell for 1? Holy shit! Saved it! Oh man, that's why you always play to the end, baby. That is why you always, always play to the end of a round. No, it doesn't prevent them from hero powering, just attacking if they get attack or get a weapon, so like Savage Roar. Or like an axe or anything like that. Oh man. Yeah, we need something to play in the first three turns. All right, bomber's fine. God, coin bomber is really risky. I don't like how risky it is, but I mean, we don't have plays for a lot of time. Fuck. Ugh. At least it burns his turn too. Unless he plays something. Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. We had some decent control options. That's good. God, Fierce Monkey is such a good card. Going to torch it. Plays a 3-health minion I can ping in Frostbolt. At least stabilize a bit. Don't have a turn 4 though. Yeah, we just keep maintaining control. Guy will come out and finish him. And we have Grand Crusader, Boulder Fist. I don't like it too much because I mean he still is a Belcher. If I'm way too quiet, by the way, just let me know. Oh, God. Alright, Bomb Lobber, do your thing. Not the best, man. I'll let him get his 6 damage to face. Or 8, actually. Oh, and the Obsidian Destroyer'd me on top of it. Oh, Jesus. If you didn't know, Obsidian Destroyer is the card that makes, like, Warrior a damn thing now. Oh, fuck. That's probably a game. I'll be real fucking shocked if I manage to draw a 2 cost. Like, I need a Flame Cannon. It's the only thing that might save me. Yeah, I know, that's a game. I'm done. You got a frothing combo right off the bat, like, oof. Frothing combo into a fucking Obsidian Destroyer? Yeah, that's game. Holy shit. Add games. A loss versus, I can't even remember what it actually was. I want to say it was a paladin. I'm guessing it was a paladin. Alright, well, let's see what we got at least. Honestly, for a 2-win, that's not the worst fate. It's not the worst fate on the planet. Oh, wait, no. Don't challenge him. No. Or watch. I mean, it's an even trade if you value packs at 100. I don't. What are my quests? Oh, two dominance quests. See what I get offered. Paladin. Anything, just get our quests. Equality. Argent Squire is real good. That's carrier is good. Warlock Knight's amazing. Argent Protector is great. Stranglethorn is really good for the reasons I stated. Out of these, Clockwork Knight, probably. Flame Juggler is great. Kill the mini-bots, incredible. Yeah, I don't have any threes. Argent Lance is fantastic. I like Argent Horse Rider more. Yeah, Fen Creeper. Consecrate. Am I at unplayable twos right now? One, two, three, four, five. A lot of these I don't want to play first. I'll go for that. Another Consecrate is really good, but Zombie Chow is amazing. I don't know. Kind of a hard call. Probably another Consecrate. My turn 2 is really strong. I'm short on 3s. Alright, and I really don't want to pull any more 2 drops. Good, Zombie Chow. Oh, Coghammer is so fucking good. Coghammer is so fucking good. Ugh. Really a good pick. I'll take the secret. Ooh, 3 drop. I really need some bombs on the top end here. Good 4. See, they say Giblin, but like, I want something here. I'll go ahead and go for that. Haunted Creeper is amazing. I really don't need to pull two drops though. Again, like, I really think I'm good on twos. How many playable threes are we at? 3, 4, 5. Be like one. I'd rather have another three drop, honestly. Kind of missing some top end is my only big concern. We have enough twos that I think we can just count on it. I'm gonna go for the five. Yeah, we have two playable ones, so I'll go for another. Two zombie chows isn't as good as just one, honestly. That's divine favor, I think. I don't know. This deck could do pretty well. We'll see, but I am going to the restroom real quick. I'll be right back, and I'll see if anyone wants to hang out. That's not a hot take. Everyone agrees Coghammer in Arena is way better than True Silver. Blessing of Kings was fine. Blessing of Kings isn't as good as it used to be. It was just a lot better plays.